Hi and welcome to my seventh video in this series about genes, and today we're going to be looking at cystic fibrosis. So cystic fibrosis is a disease that affects thousands of people across the UK, and it's an inherited disease, so you receive the alleles from your parents. So in order to suffer from the disease, you need to have both recessive alleles. You can also be a carrier of this disease. This is where you possess one healthy allele and one cystic fibrosis allele. So if we were to look at an example of two people who were carriers, heterozygous, for cystic fibrosis. Now we're going to use the letter F to represent the different alleles. Now capital F in this case would be the healthy allele, and the lowercase f will represent the cystic fibrosis allele. So if we were to look at this Punnett square, these top two boxes here, they represent the alleles contained within the sperm of the father. And so if you remember, the sperms can only ever carry half the genetic information of a normal cell, and so the sperm can either carry, in this case, the healthy non-cystic fibrosis allele and the recessive cystic fibrosis allele. And the same is true with the mother. These represent the alleles found within the eggs. And so in this case, the likelihood of the child that actually suffers from cystic fibrosis is this individual here. So there's a 1 in 4 chance of that with these two heterozygous parents who are carriers. So cystic fibrosis, the disease itself, what it actually does is it causes in the respiratory system and in your digestive system you to produce excess thick mucus. And what this can do in the case of the respiratory system is it can block passageways in the lungs, and so the types of symptoms you would expect to get are breathlessness and certain respiratory diseases such as pneumonia. With the digestive system, it can block up the tubes that lead towards the pancreas. So this can basically prevent, because the pancreas produces a huge number of digestive enzymes, it can slow down digestion. So to review, what parts of the body does cystic fibrosis affect? Well, two, mainly the respiratory and the digestive system. Okay, the lungs. Cystic fibrosis is caused by which parent and why? Because you need to receive two alleles, and you need to have, and because it's recessive, therefore it's caused by both parents. Obviously, if you receive the healthy allele from one parent, it means that you will be at worst a carrier. And then finally, if two heterozygous parents breed, what is the likelihood that the offspring will be a carrier? Draw a genetic diagram to help. So two heterozygous parents, that means that they're carriers for the disease, so that would be big F, small f. And so if you look here, this would be the father, so contained within one of the sperm is big F, and another one would be small f, and the same with the mother's eggs, one with big F and one with small f. And therefore, if we look here, you've got this individual would be homozygous, this individual would be homozygous as well. These two individuals here would be heterozygous characters, so it would be 2 from 4, so it's 50%.